Happy morning. Today's video is about conduct and duties of doctor in a witness box. And once he receives a summon, he should attend the court punctually as a rule. His evidence to take appointed time, etc. Stories. So what are the things he need to do? What are the things he should not do? First, we will discuss what are the things a doctor should do while he is in witness. First and foremost thing is he should take all records, relevant reports that must have been quoted in the box. Followed by, he should be well dressed, modest, stand up straight, be relaxed by keeping calm. Followed by, look, once you give a deposition, right? Always look into people's eye when you speak, and it gives an impression, right? It gives an impression of honesty or a trustworthy, and speak slowly, distinctly, audible. So once you speak audible, right? So no one will ask you, kindly repeat the statement, or I can't understand. So so it is an open gathering wherein whatever the statement we are about to deposit, there will be a typist. She will be recording those statements. So once we speak slowly, distinctly, and audibly, so the person who can record it properly, right? And followed by, always use a simple language, avoid technical terms to the best of your ability. Simple language wherein a common person, right? Common person here are magistrate, even lawyer, all are common persons. They may not know our technical terms, like, for example, in your anatomy, if you take medial, lateral, those words people may not know, right? So, and coming to the terms like posterior, anterior, those are technical terms, right? And even other things are anterolateral, posterolateral, and those are technical terms wherein a common person will not have, right? Common person can't understand those. So better to avoid those terminologies, always to be simpler, right? And the other do's are address a judge by such proper title such as sir or your honor. Be polite, pleasant, and courteous to the lawyer. Retain independence of your mind. A biased expert is a useless expert. Listen carefully to the questions. If you believe the question is unfair, look at your lawyer before answering. Watch for double questions. Answer to each part of the question may be different. And if you don't wish to make a statement for a particular question, then you can say as no opinion or no further comments regarding. And phrases of always use in my opinion, right? Always use this phrase, it will be suitable, even appropriate. And other don'ts, these are the things you should not do when you are in court as a witness. Don't discuss the case with anyone in court of law except the lawyer by whom you have been asked to testify. Don't be frightened or nervous. Never attempt to memorize, right? Never attempt to memorize the facts. Avoid technical terms to the best of your knowledge. Don't underestimate the medical knowledge of the lawyers and magistrate. And other don'ts are, don't avoid a question. Say, I don't know. If it's so, for no one can be expected to know everything. 7, don't use your temper. An angry witness is often a poor witness. So don't lose your temper. Whatever point of time you'd been irritated, just always keep yourself pleasant and calm. Don't hesitate to ask a question to be repeated if you don't understand it on the first instant. And other don'ts are, avoid long discussions. Point in, don't overemphasize the replies to the question from the cross-examination lawyer. If you don't wish to make a statement, say that you have no opinion or no comments. Don't use a phrase such as I think or I imagine. Always use I am of an opinion. That will be in a suitable and appropriate word to phrasal to use. And don't draw outside your particular field of competence, right? And if you are in a specialty of this doctor, you stick on to your own field and never cross the borders of other specialties and other field where you don't have an adequate knowledge. And avoid speaking on the subject which you don't have little or no practical experiences. And you can even say you don't know. That will be an appropriate answering. And do not refuse to answer any question. The medical witness has no professional privilege to do so. Don't volunteer any information beyond that has been asked for in a question.